Hi guys, you are watching Techarena. I am your host Mehul, and today I will show you that the Moto G4 Plus is still worth it after launching of Moto G5 Plus. So without wasting our time, let's get started to our video. So firstly, talking about the design of the phone, on the back we have Motorola logo with camera, flash and a microphone. On the right we have power button and volume rocker keys. On the left we have nothing. On the top we have 3.5mm headphone jack. On the bottom we have the charging port. On the front we have a speaker, the front camera and a fingerprint sensor with a microphone, the main microphone. The phone runs on 2GB RAM and 16GB ROM. This is the 2GB 16GB variant. You can also buy the 3GB 32GB variant. And it runs on Android Nougat. I have updated it, but out of the box it comes with Android Marshmallow. As you can see that this is Nougat 7.0. Coming on to the inside of the phone, as you can see, you can insert one micro SD card and two SIMs, and the SIM should be of micro size, not the standard one or the nano one. And this is the battery. Fingerprint sensor. Very fast. And talking about the battery of the phone, I used this phone for around 6 months and I felt that it has a very good battery. You can use this phone all day long with it 100% charged, and the battery will run out at the night when you charge it in the day. So that is why I am saying that the battery is for very heavy users. I play very heavy games on the phone, but then also the battery remains, not dies. Coming on to the camera of the phone, the phone has very good quality camera. I will click the selfie from my front camera and I will show you. This is the front flash of the phone and the screen only. As you can see, this is my S7H. You can also see the review of this phone. I will put the e-card right here, or you can see the link in the description also. And let's click a photo from the front back camera. So this is the back camera quality of the phone. You can see very crisp and sharp images. Very nice, beautiful. Speaker of the phone is also very good quality, and I will show you some sample songs from which you can decide the speaker quality. I will play a song, a bhajan, as you can see. So this was the speaker quality of the phone, and compared to the specs of Moto G5, I will show you the specs of Moto G5. The phone is very good in my opinion at this cost. Why? Because Moto G5 is of 17,000, the 3GB 32GB ROM variant, and the 2GB 16GB variant is of 14,000, and this phone is of 12,000, and it works as a Nexus 5X. I have also done the review of that phone. You can also check that e-card here. And let's see the specs of Moto G5, not Moto G4 Plus. So this is the Moto G5. As you can see, the price of this phone is 17,000. I'll focus a bit. And let's see the specs of the phone. The phone runs on 4GB RAM and 32GB ROM, expandable memory also, 5.2-inch Full HD, but the Moto G4 has 5.5-inch Full HD screen, and battery capacity of the both phones are same, I think. The Snapdragon 625 is a very good processor in this price range, and this is a dual SIM phone with the GPU of Adreno 506 at 6050 MHz in this price range. Very good, Motorola, keep it up. And it is a protection of Corning Gorilla Glass 3 with Android 7.0 Nougat. And what is else in this phone? Yeah, the primary camera of the phone is 12 megapixel, but the Moto G5 has 16 megapixel camera, and the secondary camera of both phones are same because they both have 5 megapixels camera. Aperture is also very good, 2.2, and the phone is 4G, very common nowadays. 3.5mm jack, luckily. And 1 year warranty for phone and 6 month warranty for accessories. And this is the Moto G4 Plus 16GB variant. The price of this phone is 12,500, around 12,500. And let's see the specifications. The camera is of 16 megapixel, 5 megapixel, 5.5 inch Full HD screen with 401 ppi pixel per inch density. And out of the box, it comes with Android Marshmallow 6.0.1, as I told you before. And it is upgradable to Android 7.0 Nougat. And the processor of this phone is of 6017 octa-core. Very good. 2GB RAM, 16GB. 4G phone, very common nowadays, as I told you before. And one more feature that Moto G5 has, that it is water resistant. It is water resistant. Yes, you heard it right. The Moto G4 is not at all water resistant. So these are the main specifications of the Moto G5 and the Moto G4 compared. And there is not much difference in these phones. You will not feel that you are using the older version of this G series. And many of my friends told me to do a gaming test of the phone, so I will play short games. Firstly, I will play this Motor Hero. Yeah, so the game has started now. We'll reduce the volume of the phone so that you can hear my voice instead of this annoying motor sound. So this is good now. Let's play the game. Oh, let's play the game. Good. Shit. Okay, let's play a different game. So let's play a different game on the phone. Piano Tiles 2. This is one of my favorite games. So overall the gaming performance of the phone is very nice. And let's do a quick speed test of the phone by opening various apps and checking that the RAM is available or not. The phone is hanging a little bit. The phone is heating up, and that's the only problem of the phone. Whenever there is a load on the RAM of the phone and while we are charging the phone heats up like a hot piece of iron. If you will touch it, your hand will burn. Let's open some other apps. Let's see the available RAM of the phone now. So as you can see that the 1.5 GB out of 1.8 GB is used. So there are some other phones also in this price range, like the Lenovo Zoom Z1, Lenovo K6 Power, and the Lenovo K5 Note, the U Unicorn, and many more like that. And please don't think that I am promoting this companies or any particular phone. And I want to show you that Google Assistant is working on this phone. I have enabled it. You can also see the video I have uploaded to enable Google Assistant in your phone right there. How are you, Google?
I'm good. What can I do for you?
Goodbye. I have no time for you.
Okay then.
So this was my opinion about the Moto G4 after the launching of Moto G5, and you can go for this phone today also, because Motorola promised that it will give update to Android O also. Motorola has given Android upgrade to Android Nougat also. So if you want stock experience in a budget price, you can surely go for this phone. If you liked my video, do subscribe my channel, hit a thumbs up for this video. This is your host Mila Roda signing off. Thanks for watching.